Would you please rise?
As the deer panteth for the water, so my soul longeth after thee. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. Strength, my shield, to you alone may my spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire, and I love to worship thee, and I long to thee.
Thank you, Nathan. Friends, we are gathered in this chapel today to praise God and to witness to our faith as we celebrate the life and grieve the death of Jonathan Stebbins. In the midst of our grief, we have come this day to celebrate his life. And at the same time, we acknowledge our great human loss. And as there is a collision in our hearts of joy and sorrow, may everything happen here today, all for the glory of God, for the comfort of this family, and to celebrate the memory of John. And may God grant us his grace, that unmerited favor, that in our pain we will find the comfort that we need for this day. In our sorrow, hope will sustain us. And even in the face of death, we are those who celebrate the resurrection, for Christ shares that with us. My name is Doyle Blanton, and I am one of the pastors here at the United Methodist Church of the Resurrection, and I am really honored and privileged to serve this family today and to honor John's memory as we walk together in this very difficult time through this day of your grief journey. I offer to you these great words of grace and hope. Dying, Christ destroyed our death, and rising, Christ restored our life. Christ will come again in glory, and as in baptism John put on Christ, so now in him may he be clothed with glory. To his dear friends, Martha and Mary, on the death of their brother, Jesus spoke these words: I am the resurrection, and I am life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live again. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I really like this part. He said, I am the Alpha and the Omega. I'm the beginning and the end. I'm the first, and I am your last. And I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore, and I hold the keys of hell and death, said Jesus. And because I live, you shall live also. Thanks be to God for these awesome promises of his grace. I invite you now to turn in your bulletins, and let us together pray our gathering prayer. Would you please join me? God of us all, your love never ends. When all else fails, you are still God. We pray to you for one another in our time of need, and for all anywhere who mourn with us this day. To those who doubt, give light. To those who are weak, strength. To all who have sinned, mercy. And to all who sorrow, your peace. Keep true in us the love with which we hold one another. In all our ways, we trust you. And to you, with your church on earth and in heaven, we offer honor and glory now and forever. Amen. I would like you to hear the lessons that the family has chosen for this day. In each of these lessons, hold one of God's great promises. The first lesson is from the epistle to the church in Corinth. Hear the reading. Listen, for I will tell you a mystery. We will not all die, but we will all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. For this perishable body must put on imperishability, and this mortal body must put on immortality. And when this perishable body puts on imperishability, and this mortal body puts on immortality, then the saying is written will be fulfilled. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? And where, O death, is your sting? For the sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Then Matthew speaks to us the word of Jesus, "Come to me, all that are weary and carrying heavy burdens." And I suspect many of you are doing that today. And he said, "I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." And then from Romans 8, "For I am convinced," said Paul, "that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers nor height nor depth nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus, our Lord." Thanks be to God for the promises of these, God's holy word. Amen.
Simplicity is gain, to bow and to turn, turn will be our delight till by turning, turning we come round, round. To turn, turn will be our delight till by turning, turning we come round, round.
I've chosen for our lesson, for this meditation today, a passage from a story, the 11th chapter of John's Gospel, when Jesus came to the death scene of his friend Lazarus and engaged his sisters in conversation. When Mary reached the place where Jesus was and saw him, she fell at his feet and said, "Lord, if only you had been here, my brother would not have died." And when Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who had come along with her also weeping, he was deeply moved in spirit and troubled. He said, "Where have you laid him?" "Come and see, Lord," they replied. And then we have the shortest verse of Scripture in the Bible. Jesus wept. And then the Jews said, "See how he loved him." May God's blessing be with this reading and our hearing of the sacred text. Amen. When life ends for a loved one or a dear friend, no matter what age or cause, those who love the one who has passed are left with the pain of grief and loss. This, of course, is heightened when life ends in such a tragic way as did John's, who died this past week at the age of 24 years. In the midst of issues that only he could explain, he made an impulsive move and took his own life. And I can only name that as a tragedy. He will be sorely missed by all of you, and most especially by his beloved family who held him in such high esteem. As I pondered John's passing, my first reaction was to remember a story that I just read from the Gospel of John, where the writer tells us of the death of one of Jesus' very close friends. Many times when Jesus would attend the religious festivals in Jerusalem, he would find lodging in the nearby town of Bethany. He always had a room, because they were his close friends, three close friends. The gospel writer does not tell the cause of Lazarus' death. We don't know. But when Lazarus' sister Mary came out to meet Jesus as he arrived into town, she said something to the effect, "Lord, if only you had been here, my brother would not have died." When a loved one tragically dies, it is a very normal reaction to say, "If only I had been there. If only, if I would have, could have, should have." And if we are not so very careful, we beat ourselves up with such thoughts. But of course, not one of us in this room today would have let John out of our sight if we had only known what was on his mind. But we didn't know. And our reaction then rests with the same as Jesus in our lesson today from verse 35 in John's Gospel. Jesus wept. And so today, we gather and we weep over the loss of life, and we turn to God and to one another for a word of comfort and some word of hope. And I will do my very best to offer that to you today. When we think of John's life spanning 24 years, let us never forget that it was only that brief few moments that caused his death. There is so much that we want to celebrate and to give thanks to God for as we remember John today. So, I don't know any better place to start than the beginning. Jonathan S. Stebbins was born in Clovis, New Mexico. It was the 27th day of September, and the year was 1990. He was the second boy born into the family, and he would be lucky enough to have a 10-year older brother named Michael. Their early years were probably typical of those of a little brother and a big brother. I know I have five bigger brothers. Sometimes the little brother probably wanted too much of the big brother's time and attention. But that relationship would blossom into a wonderful friendship, which I'm going to talk about in just a moment. At the age of 11, the family moved to Topeka, Kansas, and then in 2007, the family moved in this area to Overland Park, where John graduated from the Shawnee Mission South High School. Now, John was one of those guys who liked working. Well, actually, I think he liked the money that came from the working. Who doesn't? And he liked that more than college after graduation, and good for him for recognizing that reality within him. And he just enjoyed working and the success it brought to his life. He became an apprentice meat cutter at Hen House, making good money. And just recently, he had returned to school. He was working on his degree in project management. You see, his dream was to join forces with his big brother and become the project manager for Michael's construction work. And as I heard about his life, I'm telling you, he would have been a great project manager. For whatever John went after, he was more often than not met with success. He was driven to perfection, and he never did anything halfway. Those of you who know him know that to be so. And he expected great things of himself. And that's what causes us such sorrow. For there is no telling what John would have accomplished had he lived to exercise his many gifts and his passion for life. Michael, his older brother, says that he was good at anything he went after. He was a quick study, whether it was in playing the drums, drawing, art, or learning the construction trade. And on top of all of that, he was blessed with a quick wit, and he was always able to make people laugh. That's a gift. Ask any of his fellow employees where he worked, for they too were just a part of his extended family. Committed was a good descriptive word for John. Take, for example, this past Halloween. John decided that he wanted to be the Joker from the Dark Knight movie. Now, just buying the costume and renting a mask wouldn't do. No, he did the makeup, he bought the clothes, he grew his hair out, and he dyed it green. Now remember, we're talking about a young man who was definitely committed to excellence at whatever the cost. even if it meant having gray hair. In addition to his amazing sense of humor, he was a young man with a very tender heart, and he found great joy in serving others. So for a young man with such potential, we come today to grieve our loss and to offer our thanks and our praise to God. As I bring my personal reflections to a close, I want to return to our scriptures for today. And here once again, I want to plant in your heart three promises. The first promise of our lessons is this: death will not have the final word here. Paul writes, "When the perishable has been clothed with the imperishable, and the mortal with immortality, then the saying that is written will come true. Death has been swallowed up in victory." That is our promise today. May we remember that in God's redemptive plan, death itself will be swallowed up into life. And for this hope, we offer our thanks and praise to God. The second promise is that of soul rest. Soul rest. In the Gospel of Matthew, Jesus invites us, all of us. He said, "Come to me, all who are weary and heavy burdened, and I will give you rest, rest for our souls." And so I pray today that you, as a family and friends, will take Jesus up on his invitation to come and find rest. We commit John to his God and to our God, who has promised all of us soul rest. And for me, the greatest promise of all is found in Paul's letter to the Romans. And I want you to know today, when someone expresses an opinion about John's death, I want you to be sure to quote them Romans 8:39, where the writer says, nothing will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. I'm counting on it for John and for you and for me. As you read the litany of the things Paul names as potential challenges to God's love for us, he culminates by simply saying, nothing in all creation will separate us from God's love. And for this promise, we gather today to give our thanks and our praise to God who loves us with great passion. And as I send you forth from this chapel today, hold on to these promises of God. And you know, when you can't remember them, and when you cannot hold on to them, allow them to hold on to you. In the midst of your deep grief, allow the memories of John to wash over you as you remember his quick wit and his easy ability to provoke laughter. Give your best to the dream you have for your life. And in those moments when the shadows come, and they come for all of us, when the shadows come and you think there is no way out, please remember this: God is with us. His name is Emmanuel. And there are those who love us. And with God's good grace, you and I will find our way to a brighter day. All this I pray in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Invite you to join and pray in the Our Father. Let us pray. God of abundant love, we thank you for all with which you have blessed us even to this day, for the gift of joy and days of health and strength, and for the gift of your abiding presence and promise in this day of pain and grief. We praise you for our home and for friends, and for our baptism and place in your church with all who have faithfully lived and died. But above everything else, we thank you for Jesus, for he knew our grief, he died our death, and he rose for our sake, and he lives and prays for us now. And as he taught us, so now we pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust. The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings, your refuge, his faithfulness, your shield. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun.
Let us hear these words of committal. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend this your child, John Stebbins. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, and a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive John into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints of light. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, we pray. May we all say amen. Our service is nearly over, and I would like to remind you of a couple of things. I hope you will tell John stories today and the days to come. Keep him alive in your memory and your heart. Don't be afraid to cry. Don't be afraid to laugh. Use your wit. And as you remember him, it pays him honor and his memory. I also want to ask the persons gathered here today to take their bulletin home with them. And there are some dates I'd like you to post on your calendars for the coming year. And that is the date of his death, the date of this service, maybe even his birth date. Because these dates will be very much in the memory of his family. And I want to invite you to give them a call. Better yet, come by. Visit with them. Provide them the love and support they're going to need. It's a long journey. Grief is a deep, dark valley. And let us hold this family in our thoughts and prayers. So would you do that? And I'd be so grateful if you would. Receive this benediction, this blessing that was the third scripture that was chosen by this family. What appropriate word to leave with us this day. The very word of Jesus who said, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid." May the truth of this blessing rest upon us this day. Amen.
Shadows are falling, and I'm running out of breath. Keep me in your heart for a while. If I leave you, it doesn't mean I love you any less. Keep me in your heart for a while. When you get up in the morning and you see that crazy sun, keep me in your heart for a while. There's a train leaving nightly called when all is said and done. Keep me in your heart for a while. Sha-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Keep me in your heart for a while. Sha. When you're doing simple things around the house, maybe you'll think of me and smile. You know I'm tied to you like the buttons on your blouse. Keep me in your heart for a while. Hold me in your thoughts. Take me to your dreams. Touch me as I'm falling. Headed north to Pleasant Street. Keep me in your heart for a while. These wheels keep turning, but they're running out of steam. Keep me in your heart for a while. Sha-la. Sha-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Keep me in your heart for a while.